I'm tall and I'm thin, of an enviable height, and I've been known to be quite handsome in a certain angle and a certain light. As I entered into O'Malley's, I said, O'Malley, I have a thirst. O'Malley merely smiled at me, said you wouldn't be the first. I knocked on the bar and pointed to a bottle on the shelf. As O'Malley poured me out a drink, I sniffed and crossed myself. Pulled my hand, decided that the time was nigh, and for a moment it slipped from view. When it returned, it fairly burned with confidence anew. The thunder from my steely fist made all the glasses jangle. When I shot him, I was so handsome. It was the light, it was the angle. Neighbors are crying, friends I screamed, I beat my fist upon the bar. I bear no grudge against you, and the dick felt long and hard. I am the man for which no god waits, for which the whole world yearns. I'm marked by darkness and by blood, by a thousand powder burns. Though you know those fish with the swollen lips that clean the ocean floor, when I looked at poor old O'Malley's wife, that's exactly what I saw. I jammed the barrel under her chin, and her face looked raw and vicious. Her head, it landed in the sink with all the dirty dishes. Well, a little daughter, Siobhan, poured beers from dusk till dawn. Amongst the town folk, she was a bit of a joke, but she poured the best beer in town. I swooped magnificent upon her, as she sat shivering in her grief, like the Madonna painted in the churchhouse wall, in whale's blood and banana leaves. Her throat crumbled in my fist, and I spun heroically around to see Caffrey rising from his seat. I shut that motherfucker down. I have no free will, I cried, as I flew above the murder. Mrs. Richard Holmes, she screamed, you really should have heard her. I laughed and I smiled and I cried and I sobbed. I panted like a pup. I shot a hole in Mrs. Richard Holmes, and her husband stupidly stood up. He cried, you are an evil man, and I paused a while to wonder. If I have no free will, then how can I be morally culpable? I wonder. I shot Richard Holmes in the stomach, and gingerly he sat down. He whispered weirdly, no offense, and lay upon the ground. None taken, I replied to him, to which he gave a little cough. And with raven wings I neatly aimed, blew his head completely off. I've lived in this town for 30 years, I cried to no one, I am a stranger. I put a new bullet in my gun, chamber upon chamber. I turned my gun on the bird like Mr. Brooks. I thought of St. Francis and his sparrows. I shot down the youthful Richardson. It was Sebastian I thought of, and his arrows. I said I want to introduce myself, and I'm glad that you all came. And I leapt up on the bar and shouted out my name. Well, Jerry bellows, he hugged his stool, closed his eyes and shrugged and laughed. With an ashtray big as a fucking really big brick, I split his skull in half. The blood spilled down the bar like a steaming scarlet brook. I knelt at its edge on the counter, wiped the tears away and looked. The light in there was blinding, full of God and ghosts and truth. I smiled at Henry Davenport, who made no attempt to move. Or from the position I was standing, the strangest thing I ever saw. The bullet entered through the top of his chest and blew his bowels out on the floor. I floated down the bar, showing no remorse. I shot a hole in Kathleen Carpenter, recently divorced. Well, I caught my eye in the mirror, gave it a long and loving inspection. There stands some kind of man, I thought, and there was in the reflection. My hair combed back like a raven's wing, my muscles hard and tight, and coming from the business end of my gun was a aquarium of cordite. I turn left, I turn to the right, I turn to the left again. Fear me, fear me, fear me, but none did, cause they were dead. O'Malley's bar, O'Malley's bar.